Hey guys, what's up? I'm Michael, and this is an unplanned stream. Oops, hold on. Alright, I have to grab my headphones. Sorry about that. I always forget the darn headphones. I have to have them so I can hear certain things and not have it go on the stream. Right. Oh, I have an air conditioning day, but hopefully it won't be too bad. Anyway, I am going to work on a Blue Jay, and I'm going to start. I'm doing this on black drawing paper, and I'm going to lay it out with a white General's charcoal pencil. This is a test, actually, and I am testing a new camera setup, so you're getting the normal stream. And because I don't want to actually have the video from that, I don't want myself in the final YouTube video of it, I'm going to try this new rig I set up where I can record with my camcorder as well. So I am going to be using, I'm going to try this out. I don't know if this will even work on this paper or not, but I am going to try my Faber-Castell Pitt pastel pencils. If that doesn't work, I will go to my regular set of pastels. And if I have to do that, then I will have to run and grab something to wipe my hands on. So anyway, let's start this. I've taped this off because I have about a half inch to the border, and I want that border for framing purposes or anything like that. So anyway, I am using a photo from morguefile.com, and it is of a blue jay sitting on a branch, and I'm not going to put everything in there exactly the way it is, but I am going to put the bird and the branch that he's sitting on pretty much like it is. So let me get started. Okay, I need to make sure that my sound is right. Yes, that's right. And yeah, all right. So I am going to start right here. I'm not used to using my pastel on something laying flat, so I have to get more used to that. I'm used to standing up to do it at my easel. And this just goes all the way like this, basically. Now, to erase out anything I need to, I will be using my electric eraser, as it takes up white charcoal fairly easily. So this paper is really slick for to be doing pastel work on, but I've done it in the past. As long as I don't use something to use two different types of pastel, it usually works fine. Cut that in a little bit, and this is going to come up here, and it's actually not going like that at all, so refund this. The great thing about working on black paper is that it's, especially with pastel or white charcoal, is it's really easy to get your lines back out if you're light-handed. So this is actually going to drop about here. It comes up about right here, and then this is going to drop out. So going to sort of knot out, and swoop back out like so. Okay. And then this is sort of up here, but that's not even going to matter. It's Blue Jay is actually sitting right here. Can't really see much of his foot on this side, but that is a little bit skinnier. He has a very weird leg. His body actually Let's see here. His body sort of comes around right here and cuts back and into his tail. So I need to erase out that knot that I put in there. You can sort of see the knot up under him, how it's going, but it's not quite where I had it. I'm gonna put it like that. Okay. Oops, sorry about that. So when it gets down here, it's going to have his tail feather come in, and I'm going to have his tail feather come down to about right here, I think. Now, although I have a border on this, I want to have a bigger border, sort of a bleed area for the Blue Jay, so don't want to go within an inch of the edge, really, to hopefully make it easier to position for digital prints. And then he's got wings that come back to about here. This is really hard to tell what it is in there. Okay. This out a little bit too, because I know I'm going to have just a little bit more over here, and then I'll just draw it back in. Sorry, I have to respond. Okay, and then here basically it's got another one that sort of is coming out from back here, and it actually ends a little bit before the other one. And we're going to put it like that. Alright, now this is actually going to be about here instead. This back around. I can't even see where his other foot is, but you can see that he's got a little claw right here, and then I think the other one is about right here, so I'm going to put that there. Just sort of make it up where it will be. And I should have probably done this from the other side first. Hopefully I won't smudge out my charcoal too much. Blue jays are really not that big of a bird. I really hope that wasn't what I'm thinking it was. I am only here long enough to do a certain... let me rephrase that. I'm only here until... someone is off work and I have to go. So hopefully that was not them, or if it was, maybe they'll give me a few minutes. I have plans today, and I didn't think they were going to get off until about 2 o'clock. I think that's them though. Okay, so I'm going to go on and say that this is actually where the body is going to be, and then this is part of the head, and then there's another part of the head right here, and then the crest. Yeah, unfortunately that was him. Hold on. Alright, sorry about that. That was them, and they're like, come on, let's go. Look, I can't. I just started streaming. Alright, so right here, this is going to come up. And this is going to cut back down this way. And it looks like it gets right here. It sort of gets fluffy. And then we get the beak. The beak is black, so I'm going to leave most of that, but all right, and now let me lay out the areas that have different colors. This should actually be out here, and then this is going to pull down into here, and he's got an eyeball right here. Ooh, that's a weird... weird shaped eyeball, actually. It should be more up here. Not really a weird shape, but... okay. Alright, so on his... right here, he's solid white. And then he's more gray in this area until about here. It's alright, Tip. I'll take you down in a minute. I think what I'm going to do is get this laid out, and then I'll go deal with what I have to do, and I'll come back and finish this up. I hate to have to leave. I thought she was going to get off work at 2 o'clock. So. All right, now. This is where the really pretty parts come in. It's like a band here, another band of white, and that comes down here and right here, and then this sort of does like so. He has black tip here. That's fine. But here, so let's actually pull this out a little bit to make that fit. And then down here, have a nice little white area, and right here the whole way down there's a little bit of white as well, and it looks like there are black bands going all the way down its tail, and I'm not going to do the black bands exactly the way they are. I'm leaving a lot of this up to my imagination, if you will. This is a black area here, but I'm just getting the general idea of it. Alright, so let's see if we can't... I'll go back in with my colors and actually do that. Now the background, I'm going to do something different for it, but I'm going to go on and actually add some more twigs here and there, sort of coming off of this one. Looks like there's actually some going in front of him. we're just going to pull those straight out here. Like that. All right. Well, I can tell this is going to work great. I'm really excited that I'm getting to do this, actually. So I think I have that laid out the way I want it. And before I take my break, let's see, how long have I been going? Only 20 minutes. That sucks that I have to go so soon. Let's actually come back in here and add in some more things in the background up here. I don't want it to be really like nothing in here at all. That'll give it a little bit more interest. Okay, let me make sure that these pastel pencils are actually going to work now. I don't know for a fact that these will work on this paper, so if not, when I come back, I'll have to put in some of the others. Alright. I'm going to try this one. I don't think these have a color on them at all, so I'm just going to start up here and see though. Oh yeah, it works. I'll definitely be putting down multiple layers, but I think I'm really going to like how this does. The only thing I don't like about this setup is that I have to put my artwork a good 3 inches away from the edge so that both cameras can get it. I can adjust the webcam, pan it and tilt it, but I can't do that with the camcorder. I'm thinking maybe I should put the camcorder on the back part and then put the webcam on the other one and have it opposite and then flip it or something. I am going to try out several different blues in here at the same time. Oh, I like that one too. Let's try that one in the wing. Oh yeah, I really like that one. I'm hoping I can come back and put in the darker tones with this. That actually shows up pretty good on the camera too. So that's definitely what I want for that though. And then I'm going to go one darker just because right here it is a little darker, and I think I might be able to get that pattern with this. It's almost like a checkered pattern. I don't think I have a... I do have a black. I have no idea how this will work, so... Go with that. It works. What I really need to do is just use the black of the paper. But yeah, that works. Now I think I can come back with that whiter one and put a few highlights in there maybe. Alright, well, unfortunately, I didn't realize I was going to have to go this soon, but I will come back and work on this later tonight on stream. I wasn't planning to stream today, but I definitely will. I was very inspired to do this, so I'll be back and do that sometime soon. Sorry for having to cut out so soon, though. Alright, I am back. Let me get this set back up. I need to make sure that everything is working. Get my phone set up so it's not making a lot of noise and stuff. Alright. Again, I'm doing a Blue Jay, and I'm doing this with pastels, but I have to make sure that everything is actually working before I can go. Looks like it is. I am going to, if it'll come up, I am going to listen to some music while I work. So, I have some grays over here and white. I'm not really sure what colors I actually am using, though. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to go back with the very light one and use that. And let me make sure that my camera is working. Okay. Alright. Here we go. I'm really enjoying this new setup I've got going on where I have my reference on my tablet over here. I do wish that I didn't have to have my air conditioner on, but it's way too hot. So anyway, let's get back to it. Something really cool about this is there is just ever so slightly a little bit of blue in the feathers over on this part. And then right here, all of these sort of come from here. Okay, so this is actually the white coming into it, so that's fine for me to do it that way. Now, I think I kind of want to leave some of that shining through, that black. I think it would look better if it was white up under it, but I kind of like the black as well, so I'm going to go with that, I think. And pull this back out a little bit. The paper is actually blacker than the black pastel. That's a pretty cool thing, actually. I think I need to put gray in it anyway. Hey there. How are you doing today? And thank you. This was a spur of the moment thing. I wasn't actually planning to do a stream today. These are pastel pencils. I laid it out with my white charcoal pencil, and now I'm using Faber-Castell Pitt pastel pencils. I tend to use a lot of different mediums when I do work, so. This is just black drawing paper. It's called fine. Master's Fine Paper or something like that. Master's Touch Fine Art Studio. It's a brand that the Hobby Lobby company produces, I think. It's actually not really made for pastel pencils or pastels at all, but I have been using it for pastels for a while. The only thing is you can't use fixative on them. You have to go back and frame them or something like that afterwards. If you use a fixative on this paper before, if you put the fixative on it to start with, it'll give it tooth and you can get your regular pastels to stick to it. But if you go on and put your pastels down, then when you go back with your fixative, it'll actually make it almost black again. So it's not really good for pastels, but I'd rather use this because this was a test drawing anyway. Have to pick and see which one I think is going to be the lighter gray. This paper is really good with colored pencils, though. This is actually the first full thing that I'm going to do with these pastel pencils. I usually use regular soft pastels or chalk pastels. I mainly use these for detail work in other pastel paintings I've done. This is a blue jay. I almost think I should have put down a smoothing layer first, or a base layer. have to find my blender. I don't know if this is going to work too good or not, but see how that does if I go in and blend it and then put some more down over top of it. Maybe I better try a different, maybe a little bit darker. I think that looks better that way. I actually usually blend pastels with my fingers, but I really don't feel like getting pastel all over me today. I usually wear an apron or something like that if I'm doing pastel work. It's so easy to mess up your clothes with them. I do. This is actually from a website called morguefile.com. It is a place that has free reference photos for our artists. Let's see. Let me look it up and see what it, the actual name of it is. I don't know if I had it right. I hate to do this, but I think I'm going to have to blend this as well. I'll come back with some white over top of it. Maybe I can use this other one I have. I think that is about done there. Let me try to get his face now. I actually don't get to go out and do much photography like I used to. I used to go at least two or three times a week to a park or a river somewhere and do photography. I do landscapes. Most of the time it's something that I have made up, but I do landscapes sometimes, especially with pastel work. I do a lot of landscapes with it. By the way, the Stegosaurus I was doing yesterday is up on my DeviantArt, if you want to check it out. I'm really used to doing pastels on an easel, and so I'm not used to having something I have to put my hand down on with pastels, so this is a little bit hard for me. I really need something that I can sharpen these pencils with better. I can't get a point on them at all. I might have one more sharpener that will work. So how is that looking so far? I don't really like that leg, but I don't know what else to really do to it. Maybe that'll work. I do watercolor pencils. I have some watercolors and I have some acrylics. I have done a little bit of acrylic stuff, but I haven't really got too good with that. And I've never used the wet watercolors. I just use the pencils. Oops, there we go. I found one that seems to work. It'll at least sharpen them, but it's not getting them too sharp. Maybe this other one will. I'm going to bring a little bit of the blue into this part of his wings as well, and then go back over it with that black right on the tips. That blue over top of the white charcoal actually pops really good. I think maybe I should put some sort of brown into his leg. I'll come back in and blend all of this out to make it look a little better. And I'm going to put some other on top of it too. But I think most of the background I might do with an actual piece of pastel. I actually saw the picture of this blue jay and I had to draw it. I said that's just something I've always loved is blue jays, so I had to draw him or paint him. Pastels are called painting for some reason. I always associated dry media with drawing and wet media with painting, but for some reason some dry media is considered drawing as well, or painting as well. I'll get it out right. I'm going to grab one of my other sets right quick. I actually don't like that the way it was. The only problem with pastels is that once you put down one or two layers, the smoother your paper, the less layers you can do. But with this, just maybe two layers is about all you can do. And then if you're blending it to try to get that effect like I'm going for, it dulls it out and you have to get one more layer over top of it, and it doesn't like to work exactly right. But I'll deal with it, fix it somehow. That's almost a mud color. I don't know if you can even see it on the camera too much. See if I can't find another brown that'll work a little bit better than that. Well, that one's darker. Which sort of works for what I'm doing. Now the background in the picture I'm doing this from is gray. There's no green or anything like that in it. But I am going to try to go for a green, I think. Oh, let me grab something right quick. Okay, when you do pastel work, I don't know you, I'm not answering. When you do pastel work, you need to have a wet wash rag around, a washcloth that's damp at least. So I keep a bottle of water, spray water, and then a rag up here for me to wipe my hands on when I do that in my watercolor stuff. And you should never blow pastel like I just did. Alright, I think I'm going to put a lighter blue or something up top. I don't really want to put the same color blue he is. Thank you. found one I have never used before. Let's see what it looks like. I'll mix that with another blue. Alright. I'll have to come back in with my brown again, I guess, but it's alright. Pull that out. I actually usually do the backgrounds first and then go back with my browns or my actual stuff. So this is the first time doing it this way for me. I was too interested in actually getting the bird made. There we go. That pulled it back out. Keep putting my darn fingers in it. Thank you. I don't know. I've sort of been just going off whatever I felt like doing. Not really sure yet. How does the sky look with the streaks in it like that? I don't think I'm going to sign it on the artwork itself. I'll do that on the bottom. I like to do the final coat of the pastel as just streaks and not actually have anything, none of it blended. I think it looks better that way. Sort of want to imply that the limb or the twig is a little green, so or fresh, I guess is what you would call it. But I do need to come back in with some brown and make this bigger. This is actually the first pastel I've done in about a month and a half, I think. I was doing a bunch of them, and I decided to just do some other stuff after I got into the watercolor pencils. I think I'm done with it. It's just a test piece anyway, so I'm pretty happy with it. I think what I'll do is leave it down a little bit longer, and I'll come back and look at it in a little bit and see if there's anything I want to do to it. I do see something now, though. Right. Thank you. Well, I am not planning to stream the rest of the week, but who knows, I might be back tomorrow if I see another picture that I just have to draw or something. I'm not really sure if I'll do anything next week up until Wednesday or not, but I know on Wednesday I will be back. This week has been a test for me to see if if I want it to try to stream more often or not. And I'm trying to stream every time I do a new piece, but I'm not sure if doing the streaming is slowing me down too much or what. Usually a piece like this would take me about an hour and a half to do. But I've had a lot of fun with this one. So next week I'll probably be doing some more cartooning. I was supposed to do a cartooning yesterday, but I really wanted to do the Stegosaurus instead. So I decided to go with that. I'm still not happy with his legs. I need to do something to them. That's a little better. All right. Well, thank you very much for joining me again today and sticking with me. I'll probably try to be back on Monday. I have to edit at least one video tonight or tomorrow. Yeah, the live will be on my YouTube. I have to put them together because I started it in another stream and I had to go. I didn't realize what time it was, and actually I thought that my aunt was going to get off work at 2 and she got off at 12, so I had started right at 12, I think, and she come home and she says, "Hey, we gotta go." So I said, "Oh man." But as soon as I can get them edited together, I'll get them up on YouTube though. So, and for all of them, well, with this one, the reason I actually wanted to do the live stream was because I'm testing out another recording method as well. And I'm going to post that video over on YouTube as well. I won't have the camera and all of that in it like I have here. It'll just be the time-lapse version, just this. And it's not got my picture or any of the overlay or anything on it. But what would you like to see me do next? I'll be back, definitely. I've never tried a portrait live because I'm not too good at them, but I do have a portrait that I'm supposed to be working on, and I've just been doing some tests of it, like practice runs of it. The only problem with taping is that with this paper, it does not like to come up right, no matter how much you prepare to tape first. There we go. I do draw superheroes, but I've never really drawn them on camera too much. I've done a few of them, not many. But, I love doing comic book stuff, so I mainly try not to do too much comic book stuff because there are so many other people out there doing comics. That's why I started doing the cartooning, and there's not a lot of people doing the old cartoons like I do on my YouTube, so I want it to have something a little bit different. But I do love doing some of the superheroes. And a dragon or Spinosaurus sounds great to me too. I actually been sort of wanting to do that. If you ever take this tape off, if you don't do it at the proper angle, it will tear the paper almost every time. You sort of have to get it to come up at a 45 degree angle. Put some black marker on the spot where it come up. And, oh boy. There it is. All right. So I signed it there. I've heard of a budgie, but I don't know what it is. I've never seen them. Are you talking about, as far as the Amazon parrots, are you talking about the African gray, or like the macaw parrots, or something else? This website that I found my reference images on, it's got all kinds of different birds. I love blue jays and bald eagles, and I'm probably going to do a bald eagle sometime soon as well. I really have never done birds before. I've done the sun conure last week, I guess it was, when I done that. Alright, I just got word that my Stegosaurus live stream is now uploaded to YouTube. I had to piece it together, so I have to go edit that, and I'll post it as soon as I have it, the information edited on it, and you want to check it out, you can check it out over there for anything that you might have missed. But I will go on and get this up as soon as I can as well, and I'll do the speed art time lapse version of it too. But I'm going to go on and jump off up here. Thank you very much for sticking around and watching and all, and I'll be back sometime soon. See you later.